The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1 through 3, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 10th, 1973, in Stockholm, Sweden.
Maya sakta mana prartha jogang junyan madasre asangsayang samagrang maam jatha gashasi tachino. This is a verse from the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, which I have published, Bhagavad Gita as it is. There are many editions of Bhagavad Gita, but most of them, they have been edited to push forward the editor's own personal philosophical views. But we do not accept Bhagavad Gita in that light. Bhagavad Gita is supposed to be spoken by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, it is stated here, Bhagavan Uvacha. Those who are Sanskrit scholar, they will understand what is meant by the word Bhagavan. Bhagavan, Bhaga means opulence, and one who possesses opulences, he is called Bhagavan, the Bhutuprattaya. From Bhutuprattaya the word comes Bhagavan. Bhagavan means one who possesses all opulences. There are six kinds of opulences: wealth, reputation, strength, knowledge, renunciation, beauty. These are called opulences. If one person is very rich, he is opulent, he attracts attention of many persons. Similarly, if one person is very influential, strong, he also attracts. Similarly, if one man is very famous for his activities, he also attracts attention. Similarly, if one man is very beautiful or woman is very beautiful, he also or she attracts attention. If one is very wise, learned, he also attracts attention. These are called six opulences, and these opulences are possessed by us in a small quantity. Every one of us may possess some riches, maybe little wise or very not very strong, little strong, little quantity of these opulences are there in every person. But when you find a person that nobody possesses more than him all these opulences, the Sanskrit word is asama urdha. Asama means equally, and sama means equally, and asama means without being equal, and urdha means above. When you find somebody above him or equal to him, anyone else is as rich, as famous, as opulent, as wise, as beautiful, that person is called God. This is the definition of God. God is great means nobody is equal to him, nobody is above him in any kinds of opulence. That is called Bhagavan. So, here it is said, Vyasadeva, he writes, this Bhagavad Gita is one of the chapters of Mahabharata. Mahabharata means the history of Greater India. Formerly, Bharat, India is given name by the Westerners, but real name is Bharat, Bharatvarsha. This planet was formerly known as Ilavati Varsha, and later on, after the emperor Bharat, this planet was known as Bharatvarsha. So Bharatvarsha means not only India, but the whole planet. At least 5,000 years ago, it was known as Bharatvarsha. Bharatvarsha name is there, but it indicates only India. This Bhagavad Gita is a chapter of Mahabharata. Perhaps you know the book Mahabharata. Greater Bharatvarsha. The history of the greater Bharatvarsha. That is Mahabharata. So, the background of this Bhagavad Gita is that there was a worldwide fight, battle, called the Battle of Kurukshetra. Kurukshetra, the place is still there. If some of you went to India, might have seen it is near Delhi, New Delhi. The railway station is called also Kurukshetra. So there was a battle 5,000 years ago. The parties were two cousin brothers, and this Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. That's what is called Bhagavan Uvacha. So he is teaching Arjuna Bhakti Yoga. Yoga means the means by which you can contact the Supreme. That is called Yoga. Another Yoga means linking. So there are many types of yoga system for linking ourselves with the Supreme Absolute Truth. The Absolute Truth is realized in three phases: impersonal, localized, and personal. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that the Absolute Truth is realized by different person according to different angle of vision. Just like if you see from a distant place one mountain, you find something cloudy. If you go nearer, then you find it is something green. And if you enter actually the mountain, then you find there are so many varieties. There are trees, there are houses, there are living entities, animals, everything. The object is one, but according to the vision of the person, length of distance, the same object is realized in different phases. Therefore, the Bhagavata says, Vadanti tat tattavidas tatyam jad jnanam adhyam. The object is one, but according to the understanding of the same one, somebody is realizing the Absolute Truth as impersonal Brahma, and somebody is realizing the Absolute Truth as localized Paramatma. And somebody is realizing the same Absolute Truth as the Supreme Personality of God. Ultimately, the Absolute Truth is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. Therefore, Vyasadeva, compiler of Mahabharata, he says, see, Bhagavan was. So our this Krishna consciousness movement, the Bhagavan is called Krishna. He has got many millions of names, but Krishna name is the chief. Krishna name means the attractiveness, all attract. God must be all attract. It is not that God is attractive for one person, not for the other. No. God is attractive for all living entities. Therefore you see the picture of Krishna. He is loving the calves and cows. He is loving the trees. He is loving the gopis. He is loving the cowherd's boy. For him, for God, everyone is lovable object. Because everyone is son of God. That is stated in this Bhagavad Gita. Sarvojoni shukonteya sambhavanti murtayaja. There are different species of life and different forms of life. Sarvajuni. As many forms are there, Krishna says, Tasang Mahajani Brahma Ahanga Bija Padapita. Their mother is this material nature, and I am the seed giving father. So God is attractive for everyone. And God is equal to everyone. There is no distinction for God that here is an animal, here is a man, here is a tree. No. Every living entity is part and parcel of God. That is our understanding of God consciousness or Krishna consciousness. So we are practicing this bhakti yoga. There are different types of yoga system, as I have already explained, that God is realized as impersonal Brahma, as localized Paramatma, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the process of linking with Him, it is called yoga, and there are different processes of yoga system, out of which three are principles. Jnana Yoga, Hatha Yoga, and Bhakti Yoga. So Bhakti Yoga is the topmost. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajati jumang sami yukta tamomata. Of all the yogis always thinking of Krishna. With love and faith. It is not very difficult. Krishna says he is first-class yogi. So how to become the first-class yogi? That is described in the 7th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says personally, if we want to understand God, it is better to understand from God Himself. Instead of speculating, what is God? Better to understand God from the words of God. So Krishna is accepted by the, just like Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva is the compiler of all Vedic knowledge. He accepts Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. Later on, all the acharyas, Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, Vishnu Swami, Lord Chaitanya, they have all accepted Krishna. So far our Vedic culture is concerned, Krishna the Supreme Personality of God. Here it is also said, Sri Bhagavan was. So he is teaching how to become first-class yogi in Krishna consciousness. That is his teaching. He is saying, Maya sakta mana prartha yogam junyan madasraya. Mai, and to me, asakta, attachment. The Krishna consciousness yoga means to increase the attachment for Krishna. That's all. We have got attachment for something, every one of us. So everyone has got attachment either for his family or for some friend or for some house or from hobby or for some cats, from dogs. There is attachment. That is not to be learned. What is, we cannot, there is no need of explaining what is attachment. Attachment is there, existing in everyone's heart. He wants to be attached to somebody else. Or everyone wants to love somebody else. Love does not mean oneness. Love must be two, the lover and the beloved. So attachment is there. That is natural. Everyone knows. Now, this yoga system, Krishna consciousness yoga system, means to increase your attachment for Krishna. That's all. Therefore it is said here, maya sakta mana prartha, increasing gradually the attachment for me, Krishna says. Maya sakta mana prartha, yogang junyan, practicing this yoga system, madasraya, taking shelter of me. The madasraya means two things. You can take directly shelter of Krishna, or you can take shelter of a person who has taken shelter of Krishna. That is meaning of madasraya. That is the system of parampara. Evam parampara praptam imag raja sevidu. If you increase your attachment for Krishna, that attachment, and if you increase your attachment for a person who is devotee of Krishna, it is the same. Just like electricity. If one thing is charged with the electricity power, if somebody touches it, he also becomes electrified. We have got daily experience. From the electric powerhouse, the electric wires are distributed, and as soon as we join the plug, immediately it is electrified. Similarly, parampara system, Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. The words given by Krishna, if you carry, and it is carried by other disciplic succession, then you are in touch with Krishna. That is called yogang junyan madasraya, always being linked up with Krishna. Maya sakta mana prartha, yogang junyan madasraya, asangsang samagrang ma. Asangsang means without doubt, and samagra means in completeness. Asangsang samagrang ma. Krishna says ma means the Supreme Personality of God. Asangsang samagrang ma jatha gasyasi. As you can understand, please try to hear from me. Krishna is speaking. Personally. So if we accept Bhagavad Gita as it is, as instructed by Krishna himself, then we understand what is God without any doubt, asangsang and samagrang, in completeness. Asangsang samagrang mam jatha gyasasi tatsinu. In our present position, with blunt material senses, with four defects, it is not possible to understand what is God. We have got four defects in this material condition. We commit mistake, every one of us. We are illusion. We accept something for something. Commit mistake, illusion, and our senses are imperfect. The knowledge we gather through our senses, that is imperfect because our senses are imperfect. Just like we see every day the sun with our eyes, but because our senses are imperfect, we see the sun like a disk, although it is 1400,000 times bigger than this earth. In this way, if we analyze our senses, it will be found that our senses are imperfect. By the imperfect senses, speculating, that is not perfect. Therefore, all these speculators, the so-called scientists, philosophers, they put forward theories. Perhaps it may be like that. That means it is not perfect knowledge. But if we receive knowledge from the Supreme Perfect God, then it is actually perfect. Our process is like that. In the fourth chapter of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you will find Krishna says, evaṁ parampara prāptam imaṁ rāja sayubhiti imaṁ vivasyate yogaṁ praptamāna hamabhyam. Krishna said this philosophy of Bhagavad Gita first to the Sun God, and he spoke to his son Manu, he spoke to his son Ikkhaku. In this way, disciplic succession, this Bhagavad Gita has come down to this earthly planet, and if we accept that disciplic succession, do not unnecessarily interpret, then we understand what is Bhagavad Gita. That is the process. Our Krishna consciousness movement is to understand the Supreme Person, Krishna, as He is, without any interpretation. That is called Krishna consciousness yoga. That can be achieved, as Krishna says, always keeping center Krishna. Maya sakta manaprat. Yogam jinjan madasre. Asangsang samagrangma. Jathagasasi tatsinu. You can understand if you practice this yoga, keeping Krishna in the center, always thinking of Krishna, the form of the Krishna, then it will be revealed. Jasya devi parabhakti. Jatha devi tatha guru. This is the yoga system of Krishna consciousness. So, next verse he says, jñānaṁ tehaṁ savijñānaṁ idaṁ vakṣāmi aśeṣatā yajñātyā neha bhūya annaj jñātavyam avaśiṣyate. I am speaking to you a process of knowledge. Jñānaṁ. Jñānaṁ means knowledge. Te, and to you, ahaṁ, savijñānaṁ. Savijñānaṁ means theory. Jñānaṁ is theoretical. And vijñānaṁ means practical. Just like in scientific knowledge, the student has to pass both theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge. Theoretical combination of this chemical and that chemical makes this chemical, this is theoretical knowledge. But when you mix these two chemicals or three chemicals and produce that object, that is practical. Recently, I may say, in California University, one learned professor came there to speak about the evolutionary theory of chemicals. And he said that life is produced, perhaps you know, from four chemicals. But when one student, he said that if I supply these four chemicals, whether you can produce life. In answer to this, he said, that I cannot say. That is imperfect knowledge. If you say life is produced from chemicals, then you must make experimental demonstration. By mixing those chemicals, you produce life. That is called vijnana, practical demonstration. Otherwise, it is not perfect. Scientific knowledge means observation, then experiment. If you fail in an experiment, that is not scientific knowledge. It must be experimented. So here also it is said, jñānaṁ tehaṁ savijñānaṁ. I am speaking to you this knowledge which you can practically experience, not theoretical, simply. Jnanam tehaṁ sabhijñānam idaṁ bhakṣāmi aseṣata. Aseṣata means without any reservation, as far as possible, as far as you can understand, I am explaining. Jajgatya, if you understand this, na iha bhuya annaj gyatabham isyasate, gyatabham avasishyate. If you can understand this knowledge with practical experience, then there will be nothing to know anymore. That means your knowledge is complete, perfect. In the Vedas also it is stated that jajgatya jasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti. If you simply try to understand what is God, not try to understand, if you understand scientifically what is God, then you understand everything. Because God is everything. God is the central point of everything. Jatova imani bhutani jayante. These are the Vedic bhasana. From whom all this material cosmic manifestation has come into being. In the Vedanta Sutta, it says, janmadasya jataha. The absolute truth is that from which everything has come down. So, if you understand the absolute truth, jasmin vijñāte, sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti, then you can understand all other departments of knowledge. Therefore, Krishna says that jñānaṁ tehaṁ sabhijñānaṁ idaṁ bhakṣāmi aseṣataṁ. Explicitly, elaborately, I am saying, jajgatā, if you understand, na iha, in this world, anna, bhuya, again, annas, anything else, jñātabham avasiṣyate, there is anything remains to understand. Everything is understood. So, Krishna says, manusānāṁ sahasyeṣu kaścit jatati siddhaye, jatatāṁ api siddhyānāṁ kaścit māṁ vitti tattva. Manusānāṁ sahasyeṣu. There are living entities, 8,400,000 species or forms, and 900,000 forms in the water. Jalajanavalakhani, Thavara, Lokavinshati, 2,000,000 forms of the trees and plants. In this way, there are altogether different forms of life. 8,400,000. Don't think that the plants and trees, they have no life. They are also living entities. We do not accept this theory that the animals have no soul. No, everyone has got soul. Even the plants, trees, everyone has got soul. They have got different bodies only. It is not that only human being has got the soul, not others. No. Actually, if you make analysis, what is the symptoms of possessing soul, you will find everywhere. Even in plants' life, you will find. Sir Jagadish Chandra Bose, one of the greatest scientists of the world, he has proved by machine that when you cut the trees or the leaves, they feel sensation, pain, and that is recorded by machine. So everyone has got soul. Therefore, Krishna says, sarva jonishu kaunte asambhavanti nutvaya tasang mahajjani brahma aham bijapudak. So, here it is said, manusanam sahasesu kaschit jatati siddhaya. There are millions and millions human beings. Out of them, one is very much anxious how to get perfection of life. Because everyone is carried by the animal propensities. What are the animal propensities? Eating, sleeping, sex life and defense. आहार निद्रा भय मैथुन च सामान्य मेतत पशुभि नरानाम दीज आर द कॉमन फॉर्मूलाज बोथ टू द एनिमल्स एंड द ह्यूमन बीइंग व्हाट इज दैट ईटिंग स्लीपिंग मेटिंग सेक्स लाइफ एंड डिफेंस एवरीवन इज डूइंग दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज ओन कैपेसिटी कैट्स एंड डॉग दे आल्सो ईट दे आल्सो स्लीप they also have sex life and they also try to defend when there is danger, when there is enemy. So these things are common formulas both for the animals and human being. But what is the special prerogative for the human being? That is siddhi, how to make life perfect. Therefore here it is said, manusyanam sahasyeshu kaschit jatati siddha. Siddhaya means for perfection. What is the perfection of life? Perfection of life is no more births, no more deaths, no more disease, no more old age. That is perfection. That the people do not know, that there is possibility of attaining a stage when there is no more birth, no more death, no more old age. There are so many universities, so many educational institutions all over the world. But nowhere there is department of understanding this science, how to stop birth, death, old age and disease. In the chemical laboratory, they are trying to manufacture chemicals for stopping birth, contraceptive. But there is no medicine that after taking this medicine or these chemicals, there will be no more death or no more birth, no more old age and no more disease. You can manufacture chemical combination of medicine as counteracting the disease, just like in the Western country, the cancer disease. There are so many chemicals and medicines they are discovering. But there is no medicine, no chemical which can say that no more cancer disease. That is not possible. So actual siddhi means to overcome these four principles of miserable condition of life. That is perfection. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma mittu jara vyadhi dukho doshanu darshan. Everything is being attempted to suppress our miserable condition of life. That is going on. All advancement of science, knowledge, philosophy, theology, anything. The idea is how to stop the miserable condition of life. But the real miserable condition of life, according to Bhagavad Gita, is birth, death, old age and disease. Don't go take seriously the side miserable condition. Just like people are very much anxious to feed the hungry, the hungry man. Well, that you can do, that is nice business, but why don't you try that the hungry man and the well-fed man both will die. You cannot stop death. Either you feed him well, or he is hungry. Death is there, as sure as death. So actual benefit is, if you can stop death, that is actual benefit. Our Krishna consciousness movement is to stop death. You'll be surprised, you may not be very much pleased, but it is possible. It is possible, because we are eternal. We living entity is soul. We are part and parcel of God. We are eternal. Nitya sasatayang na hannate hannamane sarire. These are the statements. First of all, we have to understand the constitutional position of ourselves. That is self-realization. Our nature, we are eternal. We are not dying. When this body dies or annihilates, it does not mean I die. I exist. Just like my childhood body is no more existing, it is dead. My youthhood body is no more existing. So many bodies I had in the past, they are no more existing. But I am existing. I remember. Therefore I am eternal. So Siddhi means when he seriously understands that I am eternal. So why death is taking place? That is serious understanding of self-realization. Therefore Krishna says that manusanam sahasesu kosti jatati siddhaya. Siddhi means, perfection means to stop, because I am eternal. Just like when you are diseased, your siddhi, perfection means how to cure the disease, how to become healthy. That is your problem. Not that simply curing the disease, simply eating the medicine. No. The object is how to become in healthy condition. So our healthy condition is no more birth, no more death, no more old age, no more disease. That is healthy condition. So who is trying for that? No one is seriously educated on this point. And because one is not educated, he does not know that there is possibility, such possibilities, no more death, no more birth, no more disease. Therefore Krishna says, manusanam sahasreshu, out of many, many millions of persons, just like our Krishna consciousness movement, we are trying to teach this perfection of life, how to become free from these four kinds of miserable conditions, birth, death, old age and disease. But how many are joining with us? Some of them are thinking these are fictitious. No, it is fact. It is scientific. It is scientific. But people have no interest in these things. They are simply interested in sense gratification. Nunam pramatta kurute bikarma. This is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. They have become mad, simply mad, to gratify senses. But they are forgetting that this human life is meant for making a solution for all the problems of life. They are not interested in that. They are thinking by increasing the volumes of sense gratification, that is perfection. That is not perfection. You may improve the material condition of life, but you cannot live here. Just like you are constructed very nice city, Stockholm, or any European city. That is very good, but he will not be allowed to stay here. He will be kicked out at any moment. What is the solution for that? You construct a nice place, that's all right, very good. But you stay here, but you cannot stay. That is your problem. If you can solve that problem, yes, I have constructed nice place, nice city, nice country, and everything is nice, but I will stay and enjoy. But that is not allowed. Then where is your perfection? This is the problem. So Krishna says, therefore, manusanam sahasreshu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatamapi siddhyana. There are many persons, they are trying to attain that perfection and stage of life by jnana yoga, dhyana yoga or hatha yoga. There are many processes. But there is no system, or there is system, but people are not interested. What is that system? Jatatamapi siddhanam kosthid mang betti tattva. Nobody is trying to understand what is God. They are trying to understand so many things, but that will not solve their problems. But nobody is trying to understand God. Manushanam sahasreshu, out of many thousand, millions of persons, one may try to attain perfection of life, and out of such persons who are trying to attain perfection of life, some may understand what is God, what is Krishna. Therefore Krishna is trying to speak about himself in the 7th chapter especially. So it is not possible to describe all the verses, one or two, three verses we can explain. Then he says,
Bhumirapanarobayu khangamano buddhirivacha ahankarang itiyang me bhinna prakriti astadha.
Prakriti, nature. Now, first of all, we have to study the material nature. Just like the scientists, physicists, and chemists, they are trying to understand the material nature. So what is this material nature? The material nature is described here and 8 varieties. 5 varieties gross and 3 varieties subtle. The 5 gross varieties are the bhumi. Bhumi means this earth. Upper, the water. Bhumi, upper, anala, the fire. Bhumi, upper, anala, bayu, the air. And bhumi, upper, anala, bayu, khang. Khang means the sky, ether. Then mana, mind. Then buddhi, intelligence. Ahankara. Then self-consciousness. I am. I am American, I am Englishman, I am Swedish, and this I consciousness. So these are 8. Earth, water, fire, air, sky, mind, intelligence, and I consciousness. These are material 8 elements. Mind is also material. Intelligence is material. So there is cultivation of knowledge of the gross material. Just like soil expert, there are trying to understand the earth, where there is mind, where there is something. That is, analyzing the earth. Similarly, somebody is studying the light or the air, and they are all material things. There is no spiritual understanding. So, bhumi, rapa, analo, bayu, khanga, mana, mind, psychologist, they are also studying the mind, the activities, thinking, feeling and willing, and their varieties. That is also material. And ethereal understanding, so many things are going on. But they are all material. Krishna says, bhumi, rapa, analo, bayu, khanga, mana, buddhi, evacha, ahankara, itiyang me, prakriti, astadha. Krishna is claiming they are my manifestation of energy. So there is connection of Krishna with this earth, water, physical science. But we do not know Krishna. We simply studying externally, just in medical science. He is studying the external body. But within the body, there is a spiritual spark, soul. He does not know that. Dehinasmin jatha dehi kaumara jovanang jara. Tatha dehantram prapti dhirastatva namuyati. Who is accepting another body. The Darwin's theory is that the body is changing to another body. That is nonsense. That is not the fact. The soul is transmigrating from one body to another. That is knowledge. This is fact. So we can discuss if it is needed. But this is the fact. There is the soul. And these 8 elements, material elements, they are outer covering. That you have got, as you have got shirt and coat. The shirt is the inner covering, the coat is the outer covering. Similarly, the body made of earth, water, air, fire, this lump of matter is nothing but distribution of the material elements. Just like we make some machine by manipulating the material elements. This is also just like a machine. And it is stated here in the Bhagavad Gita, Jantra Rurhani Maya. We have been given this machine to move. By whom it is given? By Maya, by the illusory energy. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddesha arjuna tishtati brahman sarvabhutani jantra rurhani maya. We are given a certain type of machine, certain type of body, according to our desire, and we are moving. Just like if you have got a car, we can move from here to there. Similarly, by this body, we are moving, not only within this planet, but sometimes in other planet also, but within the universe. With this material body, we can move within the universe, material world. But if we want to go to the spiritual world, there is another universe, a spiritual world, then we have to get rid from this material encasement and transfer ourselves in the spiritual body, in the spiritual world. Then we get actually eternal life, blissful life, full of knowledge. That is our Krishna consciousness moment. So we request you to read our books. We have got many volumes of books, but we are giving information to the people of the world that you can get out of this entanglement of birth, death, old age and disease and be transferred to the spiritual world where you can live eternally with blissful life and full of knowledge. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Spiritual thinking can be used to cure bodily sickness.
Yes. That is not very difficult to understand. Just like a living man and a dead man. Living man means the body is carrying the spirit soul. And dead man means the body is there, but there is no spirit soul. But as soon as the body is dead, or the spirit soul is out of it, immediately it begins to decompose. The same body, as long as carrying the soul, there is no such thing. Therefore, if you keep your body spiritualized, then there is no question of decomposition or disease. Another example, just like if you take an iron rod and put into the fire, it becomes warmer and at the end it becomes red hot. When it is red hot, it is no more iron rod, but it is fire. You touch that iron rod, red hot, any place, it will burn. Similarly, if you make your body spiritualized by Krishna consciousness, then there is no question of disease.
Right. Jag skulle gärna vilja höra, jag skulle under en ord läsa ett stycke ur Bhagavad Gita på sanskrit. Och kanske få gärna detta stycke som börjar: Du sörjer den som icke bör sörjas och söker smycka ut ett logiskt tal och ord av lånad visdom. Vise män begråter varken livet eller döden. Den stund har aldrig funnits, och ej du, ej jag, dessa människor som ska leva.
Is requesting Srila Prabhupada to read verses from in Sanskrit, and the second chapter, verse 8 and 5 verses only.
Find out. What is that? Verse number?
Number 10, Srila Prabhupada.
What is the reading?
This is number 11, while speaking learned words.
11?
Yes.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, Asachan Annasuchastang Pragyavadang Subhasase, Gatasun Agatasunsa Nanusuchanti Pandita. The translation is, the Blessed Lord said, while speaking learned words, the Arjuna accepted Krishna as the spiritual master. First of all, he was talking just like friends, but when he saw that by friendly talkings, the problem which was present before that cannot be solved. Therefore, he accepted Krishna as the spiritual master, and the spiritual master Krishna, first of all, chastised him in this way: the asochan anusuchastham. You are lamenting on the subject matter which is not the object of lamentation. asochan. Asochanani suchastang pragyama. But you are talking like a very learned scholar. So, he mildly rebuked him that this kind of lamentation is not done by pandita, by learned scholar. That means you are rascal number one. You are fool. You are talking like learned scholar, but you are a fool. Indirectly he says that gatasun agatasumscha nanusochanti pandita. Pandita, those persons who know, just like this body. Pandita, those who are learned scholars, they know that this body is the lump of matter. Just like a nice Rolls-Royce car. It is very nice car, very valuable car. But it is after all a lump of matter. The car is important so long the driver is there. Otherwise it is lump of matter. So, those who are fools, suppose if there is accident in the car, they become bewildered. Oh, I am lost, I am lost. What you are lost? You are not this car. You are not this car. You get another car. Where is the cause of lamentation? That is being put. Why you are lamenting this body? The body is not the object of lamentation. Either it is living or dead. It is a lump of matter. This is the meaning.
Next verse.
Next verse. Next verse is Natu evahang jatunasang natang nimi janadhipa Nachaiva na bhavishyama sarvi vayam mataparam. He explained that you and all these persons, the kings and the soldiers who have assembled here, it is not that they were not existing previously. They were existing as individual soul. Or as I am also individual God, and you all people individual souls, we are existing in the past. We are now existing. I am existing, you are existing, the soldiers and other things there are. And in the future also we shall exist. The body may change. Just like in the past we are existing, the body has changed now. Similarly, at present also, when this body will be changed, we will exist in another body. So where is the cause of lamentation? This is the transition. Never was there a time when I did not exist, nor you. That means you existed, I existed. And all of them existed. Because we are eternal. This is the point. We are soul, we are not this body. Just like in childhood, I existed. In my boyhood, I existed. In my youthhood, I existed. And now I am existing. Therefore, the right conclusion is, when this body will not exist, I will exist in another body. So one should not lament for the lump of matter. One should be serious to understand what is that non-ever-existing eternal thing. So, that is education. Superficially, we are overwhelmed with this external body. That is ignorance. We should be serious to understand what is that eternal thing which is existing within this body.
May I ask you, you see that this foundation is a Christian foundation. And I wonder what is your personal opinion about the main picture in the Gospel, the Jesus Christ?
I do not know much about him. What is that? You know? Anybody knows?
The main feature of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Yes, what is it?
Jesus.
What is your opinion about his main teaching?
Yes, but main teaching, so far we read Bible. Jesus Christ said, thou shalt not kill. But there you are, everyone is killing, that's all.
Yes,
the first commandment is violated. It is clearly said, thou shalt not kill. But when I ask any Christian why you are killing, he cannot give me a satisfactory answer.
But him himself, Christ himself, not the what is...
We offer our all respect to Jesus Christ. Yes. We call Lord. We offer our sincere respects to him. That is all right. His teaching is all right. He gives you the message of God. You are doing the same thing. So therefore he is bona fide. Anyone is spreading the knowledge of God, he is bona fide, representative of God. So that we admit. But unfortunately, his instructions are not being followed. That is our lamentation. Otherwise it is very nice.
Which man has to evolve through.
Yes.
A spiritual being having entered or faced the way of man, can he ever again reincarnate in the world, in the kingdom of animals?
Yes.
What happened to his consciousness, which he has achieved as a man during that time, which is in the animal kingdom?
Yes, consciousness is according to the body. Just like when you were a child, your consciousness was different because you had a different body. In your childhood, you might have talked so many nonsense things. Your father and mother did not care. He's a child. But if you talk such nonsense things now, then you'll be differently considered. Because the body is different. So consciousness is there according to different types of body. So, in this human form of body, we have got our consciousness very developed. Now, we should utilize this consciousness to understand what is God, what is our relationship with God, and act accordingly, then we become perfect. But if we do not take advantage of this human form of life, you keep our dog's consciousness eating, sleeping, mating only. And then you do not know what kind of body you are going to get next.
If I come in contact with Krishna movement now, will that in my next life get me a human body?
Not only human body, you are getting you have got already the spiritual body. Now it is covered by this material body. So if you develop your Krishna consciousness, then you are not going to be covered by material body again. You keep in your spiritual body. So that in spiritual body, you go to the spiritual world and live with Krishna. That is the highest perfection.
In meeting you here now would make sure that he will get a human form in his next life.
Yes, if you are in Krishna consciousness, even though you cannot finish it properly, still you get the chance of getting a higher standard human form. That is stated in the Bhagavad. Suchinang simatangi he yoga bhrashta sanjayate. One who could not finish this yoga system of Krishna consciousness, he gets his life again as a human being in very rich family, or in a very pure family. So at least human body is guaranteed. Even one fails to complete the Krishna consciousness. Because he gets another chance. To get birth in a rich family means he has no economic problem. He can completely engage himself to understand what is God. But people are not doing that. As soon as he gets birth in a rich family, he thinks that for nothing I've got so much money, let me engage in sense gratification. No guide. Otherwise, this is a chance. Similarly, in a pure Brahmin family also, the family is already enlightened. Just like the children of our students, from the very beginning, they are getting chance to understand Krishna. There is a very good chance from childhood.